What if I tell you, you might pay a whole lot more if you are just a casual gamer? Hey guys, Wano here and welcome back to another video. If you have ever watched my videos on budget gaming PCs in South Africa, you might have noticed that I tend to focus on integrated GPUs as well as the cheapest possible options you can find. That is literally the definition of budget gaming PC. Because of that, the price stays reasonably the same if you are a casual or a competitive gamer. When it comes to mid-range gaming PCs though, it's an entirely new discussion altogether. We have room for some change. Let's start with an obvious question. Do you want to play competitive esports titles such as CSGO, Rocket League, League of Legends, or Valorant? Or would you rather play AAA titles like Assassin's Creed Valhalla, Cyberpunk 2077, or the like? Some might say both, like me, but most would prefer one or the other. Before we go on, I would recommend tapping or clicking that subscribe button if you are in any way interested in videos about the latest games or PC tech in and around South Africa. Also, liking the video really helps me get noticed by YouTube's algorithm, so that would be appreciated.
Moving on.
You've probably wondered by now why I have said that the price can range from 10,000 Rand to 25,000 Rand depending on what you need. Well, here's the deal. If you're a casual gamer that wants to focus on playing big titles, that means you're going to need a much beefier gaming PC. In turn, that obviously costs a lot more. Let's see. Let's focus on evetech.co.za for this one. If you want to, you should be fine buying a complete PC with a few extra components that will be needed of some swapping because they are trash. A good example of this is the GT730 that you will get with most of these PCs. Where would you ever need a GT730 in a gaming PC nowadays? Sorry for everyone who has a GT730. So in one scenario, you can buy the Ryzen 7 5700G workstation at evetech.co.za along with the XFX Radeon RX 6600 XT. That will bring you up to a total of 22,300 Rand. This will be able to play most AAA titles at least high settings 1080p and even medium to high settings at 2K resolution. This is of course at least 60 frames per second or more. Another scenario would be buying the Ryzen 7 5700G budget gaming PC at evetech.co.za. This will be at a total of 20,000 Rand. The bonus with this build is obviously that it's cheaper than the previous one, but at an obvious downfall. The GTX 1660 Ti doesn't perform nearly as good as the RX 6600 XT, so you would not be able to play at such high frames. It has to be noted that you should still be able to play most games at decent frames 1080p though. The last option would be to go the Nvidia route if you are an Nvidia lover. Here you can buy the Ryzen 5 5600X with a RTX 3060 12GB for 23,000 Rand. The positives of this build are obviously the RTX card for those who like Nvidia more and the fact that you should be able to play RTX games better than with the AMD equivalent. You also get a cooler case here, so there's that. With this build, you can expect just about the same frames as the one with the RX 6600 XT within margin of error, except obviously if you play RTX games. Now that we have the casual gamer out of the way, we can go over why a competitive mid-range PC might cost a lot less than a casual one. Competitive games are usually optimized really, really well, so you don't need such a good PC to play at higher frames. This is where my old buddy, the integrated GPU, comes along once again. As long as you can get around more than 144 frames in most esports titles, you should be fine. So instead of worrying so much about the GPU to get decent frames in AAA games, spend more time worrying about the rest of your system. Remember the complete PC from the beginning? Yeah, that's the one. I would go for the Ryzen 7 5700G system, but the one without the GT730 in. This will bring the total up to 10,400 Rand. Some people might disagree with me when I say this is a mid-range gaming PC, but who knows? If you disagree with me, let me know in the comment section down below and tell me what you think the basis is of a mid-range gaming PC. Well, that's it for this video. If you want to check out any of the products I mentioned, I'll link them in the description down below. If you like this video, please consider tapping that like button and sharing it to someone who might need it. With all that being said, I hope you enjoyed. Let me know in the comment section what you think about all this, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers!